那些商人能把你搞到记不任何东西，尤其是那些不寻常的家的人。这一切都是为
the most professional stuff on the market. I actually had some damn money. I would be, you know, it would be nice to have some damn money. Very much appreciated.
Good job, Lao Wei. I see you found the first relay. Now hack it and turn off its security protocols.
Anyway,
access granted.
One down, two to go, my friend.
Yes, we are looking for some lady who owns the Triads and some money. We are deactivating these relays to find her.
Access granted.
Good. Second relay is down. Only one remaining.
I heard that. Come out. What the hell is that? Good. Second relay is down. Only one remaining.
Access granted.
Excellent work. I'm starting the triangulation now. Should have a location very soon. And I've got it. Jaya is hiding in an apartment building called the Hengsha Court Gardens in the Yuzhou district. I'm sending you her coordinates. Get over there and get us the money she owes.
Who are you? Another one of Tong's thugs? Well, get out! I told him I won't pay another credit!
That's a shame. Because Tong wants that money, and I'm not leaving till I collect it. With or without your consent.
I will not be bullied. I am sick and tired of Tong's lapdogs coming here, stealing my money!
Stealing? They got you the augmentation you needed, and they expect you to pay for it. Not the most charitable thing to do, but I would hardly call it stealing.
Are you really that gullible? Tong doesn't run a buy-now-pay-later operation. It's more like a buy-now-pay-forever. Listen, I just started as a broker. Most other brokers come from rich families. They paid for augments that give them an incredible edge in the business. There's no way I could afford anything like that through legal channels.
So you cut a deal with a crime syndicate?
I didn't study this hard to end up with nothing. Once I made enough money, I offered to pay for the aug. But no, what they want is part of my monthly profits. They say they're entitled to it since it's their upgraded enhancement chip that helped me make that money.
How much are they asking from you?
A couple hundred credits every month. Doesn't look like much. But in the long run, let's just say they've made a very lucrative deal. Especially if you consider I'm not their only client.
How did you meet Tong?
The same way most people end up meeting Tong. I was hurt, and one of his hounds smelled blood. They came to me and offered me help. I was intelligent enough to know it was a bad idea, but angry enough not to care.
Couldn't you work without the augment? You wouldn't have gotten into so much trouble if you'd played by the rules.
Play by the rules? Let me tell you a little story about playing by the rules. I come from a poor family. My father, my mother, my two sisters, and three brothers, none of them ever amounted to much. When I tried to do better, when I made efforts in school, they said I was wasting my time. I got into business school. And again, they said I was wasting my time. that I could never compete with all those rich kids and their tutors and extra classes.
Well, you did.
I did. I finished top of my class without the extra help and special attention, only through blood, sweat, and tears. And then what did my classmates do? They cheated. They once again bought their way to success. And what did my family say? That I had wasted my time. I was just supposed to accept defeat after all the efforts I've made. No. No way.
Oh man, she's really doing fucking nothing.
It's a nice sob story, lady, but it doesn't change a thing. In the end, I can't leave here without that money.
Then you'll have to take it, because I am not going to give it to you.
Follow me. I don't give a shit. This game decided to be different.
What can I get you?
Hey, about that job?
You found Jaya yet? You need to get back the money she owes us.
Here's Jaya's augment. I guess this means your investment has been returned.
What are you talking about? Where's the money she owed us?
There is no money.
This was not our deal.
Maybe not. But think of it this way. Jaya was becoming a problem. I helped you get rid of that problem.
This wasn't helpful at all, Guaylo.
Just to get it done, you know. I don't spend. Well, I've seen some YouTubers. They are. Stick around. I guess they're making, you know, big money. Well, I say big money. They're making money. Let's just put a big bit of that. They're making decent amounts of money for every video they put out. I've got so far since I've released about 60 videos or something, I've made a single penny from 60 videos worth of content, but I've only made a couple of hundred for each video. Let's take a break. Yes, but I'm just, anyway, like I say, I'm just, I can't remember what I was talking about.
Jensen, I was on my way out.
What are you doing here, Malik? I told you, I got this one.
I know, I didn't do anything. Trust me, Van Bruggen's all yours.
Hang on a second. Something's wrong. What is it? Why are you here?
It's nothing. I mean, can't a girl have secrets?
Depends on the secrets. I doubt the boss would appreciate his chief pilot getting into trouble. Especially this far from home.
I can take care of myself, Jensen. I had business to attend to. Personal business.
Malik, come on.
Fine, since you're so damn curious. Years ago, I used to live here, remember? My friend, my best friend, Evelyn. She was like a sister to me. Made living here fun. But then there was an accident. She's dead.
I'm sorry, Malik.
Wait, Jensen, let me finish. I thought I was okay with it, but I know. I know she didn't just die. She was killed. Murdered. Her damn scumbag boyfriend did it. I know he did. I knew he was trouble right from the start, but she just wouldn't listen to me.
Malik, easy. If your friend was murdered, the police would have suspected something. They would have investigated.
That's just it. There was no investigation. They said she fell down a flight of stairs like it was some kind of freak accident. But her wounds, the way she died, they don't add up. It's right here in the damn blood spatter analysis.
Blood spatter? You've seen the police report?
Yes. A friend left a copy of it in a pod here for me to pick up. Listen, I know it sounds crazy, but I think there's been a cover-up. I just have to prove it. If I could get my hands on the autopsy report, the one that never surfaced, I know I'd get the truth. Except...
Why do I suspect I'm about to get dragged into something?
Look, Jensen, I'm sorry. I know Van Bruggen is the priority here. And I told you it was my business and I could take care of it. It's just... The more I think about it, the more I realize I'm in over my head. I'm just a pilot. I'm not a damn cop. But I need to know the truth.
Now, I would really like to decline her. Unfortunately, you know, the XP, money, that sort of thing.
You said you've seen the police report. Who gave it to you?
An old friend who was also a good friend of Evelyn's. He used to work for the Shanghai PD. He left a copy of it along with a few other things concerning Evelyn in a pod here for me to look at. He also left some instructions on how to contact someone at Lim for the autopsy report he's convinced was intentionally buried.
Why would Lim have anything to do with Evelyn's autopsy report?
Well, if you haven't noticed, the Chinese government has been outsourcing branches of its public services for years. Bell Tower polices the streets, and nowadays Lim does more than just cosmetic surgery. They're often contracted for special cases like Evelyn's.
And what made Evelyn's case so special, you think?
Her boyfriend, Lee. He was at the scene. He had Evelyn's blood on him and tested positive for alcohol and drugs in his system. With his rap sheet, it wasn't looking good for him. But his family, they're on a lot of boards with deep pockets and a lot of reach. They wouldn't suffer the embarrassment of having their son indicted on a suspected murder charge.
Sorry, I just really don't care what she has to say. It's just so boring. I'm just messing with my phone at the moment.
Why do you suspect Evelyn's boyfriend had something to do with her death?
Because he was poisoned, right from the start. Born into money and influence, but never once assuming responsibility for anything. I don't think he's worked an honest day in his life.
So he was a wealthy, pig-headed asshole. If that was reason enough to accuse someone of murder, half the world would be in the pen.
No, there's more to it than that. He's known for violent outbursts, domestic altercations. He nearly killed a kid over some stupid gambling feud. The problem is, his family made him untouchable, even to the police.
And Evelyn was okay with all of this?
She always tried to see the good in people, give him the benefit of the doubt. You could say that's just being naive or even stupid, but I think she was just innocent.
Tell me about Evelyn.
She was beautiful, carefree, loved to have a good time. I met her during my internship for a private transportation and logistics firm here in Shanghai. She was a great pilot, too. Knew how to feel the currents, to push the bird just so. Too bad her talents for reading the wind didn't translate to reading guys.
How so?
She was always getting into trouble with the wrong crowds. And it always had to do with some boy. She knew I didn't like him, her boyfriend at the time, Lee. It drove a wedge between us, and when we parted ways, it wasn't amicable.
I understand.
She was a good girl, Jensen. She deserved better.
Malik, don't take this the wrong way, but I need some kind of incentive to justify any complications that might arise.
I'll see what I can do, but I can't promise anything.
This autopsy report, once you got your hands on it, what were you planning on doing next?
I'm not sure. Like I said, I'm a pilot, not a cop, but I felt I had to do something while I had the chance. Maybe once you get the report and we know what it says, we can improvise.
Okay, I'll help. What do you need me to do?
My lead. He works for Lim. He's a systems technician who apparently has access to their entire database. He's willing to hand over a copy of Evelyn's autopsy report.
So you want me to meet him and get the report? Is that it?
Yes, but he'll only respond to a certain phrase. Death and life have their determined appointments. To which he'll reply, riches and honors depend upon heaven.
Christ, Malik, this is starting to sound like something out of a bad spy movie.
I know. He's just trying to protect himself. I didn't pick the damn quote. So just play along and remember the line, okay? You'll find him inside the lobby of the Lower Hangzhou Limb Clinic.
Does this guy have a name?
None that I know of. But he apparently goes by the handle Anonymous X. I know, I know.
Anonymous X. Okay, anything else?
Yeah, before I forget, everything concerning Evelyn's incident, newspaper articles, the police report, limb details, it's all inside pod 009 here in the hotel. You should read over everything if you can.
Pod 9. Got it.
I need to go. Contact me with any updates and... Thank you. I really appreciate this, Jensen.
我要去洗个澡。这么几圈就累了。我也不怎么想要去。告诉你，我不那么多的房租。到最后还要跟其他十二个笨蛋家伙。用一个浴室，这个地方有很多地方跟那个监牢啊没什么不一样。那你打算找房东谈谈？
Earth Seeker's fear is in serious trouble, Eliza. And it's time that we as a species step up to make things work. Our best chance of doing this is to modify ocean temperatures through a combination of iron.
Forget it, man. You're not my type.
This isn't a booty call, Van Bruggen. This is about you and some friends of yours I met in Detroit.
Detroit? Yeah, okay. I got it now. You and Seraph, right? You were there when I had to pull the plug.
So you admit it. You were running the mole.
The heck, man. Just the heck. Worst decision I ever made taking that gig. As you can obviously see.
You attack my people, Windmill. You hope to walk away from this. You tell me what you know.
Down, boy. I've got no allegiance to that backstabbing bitch who hired me. Especially after she painted a target on my back. The girl you want is Zhao Yunru. Tai Young Medical CEO.
Tai Young Medical? They're Seraph's biggest competition.
How do you think they got that way? Zhao doesn't like competition, see? So she uses hack attacks, blackmail, extortion, anything she can do to destabilize him. No offense, but Seraph was just the latest in a long line.
You got any proof of this?
There's a surveillance recording in the Tai Young Tower. I stashed it on the server in case I ever needed an insurance policy.
Not a very smart place to hide it, seeing as you don't work there anymore.
Things got hot before I could move it. And now, I got you to get it for me. Of course, you can't just walk into that place. You're gonna need an employee card encoded with your biometrics to use the TYM shuttle.
Well, what do you know, Windmill? I've already got an employee card. Just needs the biometrics from my passport to work. So start encoding.
There you go. All shiny and bio-encoded, just like I promised.
Where do I find this recording?
On a surveillance server in the TYM tower. But that badge will only get you into the lower city factory via their employee shuttle.
And how am I supposed to get up to the tower from down here?
Never said it wouldn't require a little finesse. Look, The tricky part is getting through the Pangu. But you're a resourceful guy. I have faith in you.
Right. And after I'm through the floof?
You'll be in the upper city tower. The server you want is in the central security hub. The login and password are on this. Now, about my reward.
Tie your medical, man! They're here!
Banner! I want that hacker dead!
You gotta help me, Jensen! They're gonna kill me!
And that concerns me how?
Oh, come on, man! I helped you out. At least give me a weapon so I can defend myself.
Sorry, that was on my phone again. I really don't give a shit. His face has gone really peculiar. I honestly never seen that before. Now, it really doesn't matter what you choose here. Any weapon you give him, he'll survive. If you do decline, then he'll end up dead. But any weapon, I'm going to give him the revolver because I've only got two shots for that.
Alright, fine. Take this and get out of here.
Oh, thanks, man. I won't forget this.
Consumed all of my attention these days.
This is the spot.
You're referring to the Pangea Project, the cooperative global initiative that aims at healing our world.
Every corner! And it's time that we use this. As possible. Oh,
to some guy having, you know, a minigun, but obviously you got to wait for the bow to spin up, and that would give me enough time to run.
Malik, get Pritchard on the line. Tell him I need everything he's got on the Tai Young Medical Building. Schematics, blueprints, everything.
That might take a while, Jensen.
Yeah, well, he's got as long as it takes for me to find this Tai Young shuttle Van Bruggen talked about and ride it to their factory. Jensen out.
Excuse me, do you know where the Limb Clinic is?
Yeah. Earth Ecosphere is in serious trouble, Eliza.
Our best chance at doing this is to modify ocean temperature
through a combination of iron, steel, and
geothermal energy.
As soon as you don't get a job, I can hook you up. My friend works at it.
Can't you see I'm busy? Go bother someone else.
Something, something, death and taxes, Confucius.
What? Wait, that's not it at all. That's not even close.
Does it matter?
Of course it matters. Otherwise, how am I supposed to know your... You were supposed to say, death and life have their determined appointments. Then I say, riches and honors depend upon heaven.
Okay. Death and life have their determined appointments.
Riches and oh, never mind. You ruined the whole thing. Just meet me outside the clinic. It's safer for us to talk out there. Turn left from the front and go down the stairs. I'll be waiting at the corner.
Here. Come on now.
That was hardly what I would call a smooth interaction. I could get into serious trouble for this, you know.
Sorry, I'm new to this spy game stuff.
Right. Well, you're not exactly what I was expecting. I was told I would be meeting a girl. How do I know you're not an imposter or some sort of double agent? Don't think I don't know this could all just be an elaborate trap to set me up.
Look, no offense, Mr. X, or whatever your name is, but I really don't have time for this. So if you could simply just give me what I came for, I'll be on my way.
Yes, yes. I have it right here. Evelyn Carmichael's autopsy report. Here, take it.
Thank you.
I trust you will put this information to good use, because accountability and justice is at an all-time low, I'm afraid. It pains me to see this once great city, which stood as a bastion for reform and progress against our oppressive communist origins, succumb to the trappings of corporate bureaucracy and petty corruption. Corruption so often typical of your Western governments.
Whatever you say. Now, if you don't mind, I really must be going.
Well, there is still the matter of my payment. 1,000 credits was the agreed-upon price, I believe. Isn't that right?
A little piece of advice. When attempting to extort money from someone, don't give them what they want before trying to rip them off.
What? What? You mean you aren't going to pay? But I risked everything to get you that file.
Chalk it up to a learning experience and move on.
You scoundrel! You'll regret this someday. You just mark my words.
See you later, X. Malik, I just got the autopsy report. No drugs or alcohol in Evelyn's system. And her estimated time of death doesn't fit Lee's story. She did die from a head wound, but not one that matches the evidence found at the scene.
I knew it. It couldn't have been just an accident.
There's more. Evelyn was pregnant. Malik?
I'm here. We can't let him get away with this, Jensen. He's guilty. He has to be. Can you go to his apartment?
And do what?
Get proof. Get something. I'm sending you the coordinates. Contact me again when you're there.
Oh, I need to go to that limousine again to buy.
You shouldn't be here. Get moving.
Wait. See ya.
Access granted.
Now we're supposed to find read out those autopsy reports and stuff, and then go through his apartment. Now I'm not gonna make you guys suffer through that because I had to suffer through it myself. So I already know where all the stuff is, thankfully, so you know, you don't have to spend 5 or 10 minutes watching.
Malik, I'm inside Lee's apartment. Doesn't look like anyone's home.
Damn. Okay, look. Lee isn't smart enough to properly cover his tracks, so look around. Maybe you can find something suspicious.
Access granted.
Malik, it looks like Hong Sr. was upset with Hong Jr.'s behavior and threatened to cut off his inheritance if he didn't stop whoring around. Sounds like he considered Evelyn beneath the family name.
And if he knew she was pregnant, I can't believe Lee would do something like that just for money.
Speaking of money, the Hong family seems heavily invested in both Bell Tower and Lim. That could explain the cover-up and lack of a proper investigation. I'll keep looking. I'm sure there's more here.
the Hive. I should have guessed Lee would be there. It's pretty much a second home for him.
Wait a minute, you heard that?
Sorry, Jensen. I don't like invading your privacy like this, but it's important. Plus, this gives me an idea. When you're done looking around Lee's apartment, head to the Hive. Contact me when you're there.
I'll stick around a bit. I'm sure there's still more to find. Malik, I think I got a probable murder weapon. A broken clock. The kicker is the hands line up roughly with Evelyn's TOD. Coincidence?
That's a hell of a stretch. You really think?
If Lee's as dumb as you say, maybe. We'd need lab tech analysis to confirm, but if there ever was a smoking gun, it fits. I'll make one last sweep to make sure I got everything. Malik, I found a baseball bat, but it looks clean. Almost like it's been washed recently.
Maybe Lee washed Evelyn's blood off of it.
That's what I'm thinking. But I'm not sure it could inflict the type of laceration she had. Okay, I think that's it. I'm heading to the Hive now. I doubt we'll find anything else in here without calling in a forensics team.
Sounds good.
So off, it's ridiculous. Sure to do before I leave for TYM.
Malik, I'm in the Hive. What's your plan?
Find Lee and talk to him. I want you to convince him you know exactly what he did to Evelyn and why. If you can make him panic, I'm willing to bet he'll spill his guts. Just make it look like blackmail. If he's willing to pay to keep you quiet,
what
he's
you
basically
want,
tying his own noose.
Is your name
I'll
Lee
listen
Hong?
In and record
yeah,
everything.
Maybe it is.
Got it.
Maybe it is. What's it to you?
I want to talk to you about Evelyn Carmichael.
Ev... Man, piss off! I already told all you knuckles all there is to say.
Relax. I'm not with the police. I work private. And you could say I specialize in cases like yours.
If you ain't police, then what the fuck you want?
A simple proposition. I have proof that shows you murdered Evelyn. And I want you to pay me 2.5 million credits to make that proof disappear.
2.5? Bullshit. You ain't got shit on me, Narco. I ain't paying you shit.
I strongly suggest you reconsider.
And I strongly suggest you get the fuck out of my face. Cause unless you got your proof right here, I ain't got shit to say to you.
Alright. Let's start with the police report. I know your story doesn't match up with the evidence at the scene of Evelyn's fall.
Oh yeah? And why's that?
Because the police report itself was falsified. Why else would that be, if not to cover up a weak alibi?
Man, you gotta be kidding me. That's some weak-ass shit right there.
Not only does the evidence not add up, but neither does your testimony. You lied about why Evelyn fell down the stairs in the first place. You said you'd both been drinking heavily prior to the accident, and the reason Evelyn fell was because she was drunk. We both know that isn't true.
Man, that shit was in the papers.
Now, if the evidence doesn't fit and your story was a lie, then how did Evelyn die on that night? Well, the answer is pretty simple, really. You killed her. But how? By hitting her in the head with that antique clock you keep so prominently displayed in your apartment. The lacerations on her head, the intracranial hemorrhaging, it's the perfect match.
In my apartment? How the fuck do you know what's in my apartment?
And like any good crime of passion, you needed motivation. Something to fuel your violent outbursts. What did Evelyn say or do to make you murder her? She told you she was pregnant, and you panicked. Faced with the prospect of losing your easy way of life, you struck out at her in anger.
How? That's impossible.
But now the final piece of the puzzle. Why was Evelyn's death never considered a murder investigation? Because your family, one of the wealthiest and most influential families in Shanghai, covered it up. But whose silence did they buy? Bell Tower. Your family's sizable investments in Bell Tower assured they would turn a blind eye to any of your run-ins with the law, no matter how serious.
Fuck this shit, man! And fuck you!
I can help you, Lee. But only for a price.
Alright, fuck! I can't believe this shit! I'll pay you, man! I'll pay you, just... What do you need from me?
Details. Let me hear your side of the story, and then we'll move on from there.
I don't know! Evelyn, that stupid bitch! She was going to ruin me. I didn't mean to kill her, okay? Evelyn wouldn't shut up about us, about the baby, so I hit her. I just wanted to make her shut her stupid mouth. But the dumb bitch started freaking out. So I hit her again until she finally stopped screaming. When I realized what I'd done, I panicked. She was barely breathing, so I carried her to the stairs near my apartment and dropped her. I had to make sure it looked like an accident. I had no choice. She trapped me. She just wanted my money. I would have been ruined.
I need to go. We'll be in contact again soon.
Huh? What? What about the evidence? And the money? Where the fuck you going?
Goodbye, Lee. Malik, please tell me you got a recording of all that.
Oh my god, Jensen, I could kiss you right now. I can't believe you got him to confess so openly like that.
To be honest, it was easier than I was expecting. You were definitely right about Lee. He's not exactly the sharpest tool in the shed.
Well, don't get too cocky just yet. Before I send our little friend's confession off to the local media and authorities, I want to get some Shanghai street justice first. There's a control panel linked to the Hive I need you to hack. Uploading the coordinates now.
Malik, it's hacked.
Verifying the signal. Come on.
Well, I'm gonna leave it there for now. Thanks for watching, etc.